You're watching Altitude Sports and Entertainment.
You're watching the NLL on Rogers Sportsnet.
The best of the National Lacrosse League have come out to play, and there's little doubt you'll be in for quite a show today. The beasts of the East include a pair of legends, seven-time scoring champ John Tavares, and here's a scoop, Jim Veltman. He's good. And never take this Nighthawk, John Jr., for granted. The Western Conference Hit Parade features plenty of solid gold, as in Gavin Prout, always capable of a mammoth contribution. And Tracy Koleski's skills are simply sensational. The 2006 All-Star Talent Pool is one of the deepest ever. And we are not joshing. It's next.
The 2006 NLL All-Star Game on Rogers Sportsnet, presented by RBK.
Downtown Toronto on a beautiful Saturday. Beautiful for the great game of lacrosse. It's the 2006 National Lacrosse League All-Star Game, matching the best of the East against the Top Guns from the Western Conference. Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome no matter where you are looking on today. And we think we've got a great display to show you this afternoon. And we begin with the Eastern Conference, where really, Brian, they're led by some of the true legends of this game.
Absolutely. And starting with John Tavares, in his last game, he's got a 1,091st point, which puts him tied with Gary Gate all-time in points, 300 points ahead of the next closest person. And this guy's 37 years old, and he's still not slowing down. Johnny Grant is another guy, top 10 all-time in scoring. He actually has the best points per game record for anybody, over 6.5 points per game. Great hands. And Colin Doyle is coming off a fantastic season last year, was the league's leading scorer, MVP of the regular season, and MVP of the championship game. He's having another great season, second in points in the league.
He is indeed. The Western Conference focus is one on players who are the up-and-comers. They're the stars to be, and I know one player you're excited about watching is Brody Merrill of the Portland Lumberjacks.
Absolutely. I'm really excited to see Brody Merrill playing in his first year in the league. First overall draft pick, 23 years old. And Craig Kahn, another young guy, 22 years old. Brody Merrill, who is a defensive player, scored 2 goals, 5 assists last game in a big win against Philadelphia. The first time a player has won, a defensive player has won Rookie of the Week and Offensive Player of the Week at the same time. But also Craig Kahn, he's hot now. 22 goals so far in only 6 games.
Indeed. He has been on a tear, as have the majority of players participating. And we will meet all of them when we return to the Air Canada Center after this.
Have you ever had a diet fail because you were hungry all the time? If you have, don't worry. It's not your fault. It's almost impossible to lose weight if you're always hungry. Hi, we're the creators of Right Size Smoothies. The secret is a cutting-edge appetite manager called Appamine. It's in the smoothie. You drink the smoothie, it knocks out your appetite and helps you burn more calories than you take in safely and without being hungry. And that's what leads to weight loss. Because it's such a great product, we're going to do something crazy here. Call within the next 15 minutes, and we'll let you try Right Size before you buy it. Here's how it works. Just pick up the shipping and handling fee, try the smoothies for 2 weeks, and either you lose the weight or you'll never pay for them. Operators are standing by for the next 15 minutes, so call now.
Call 1-800-318-9085. Call now to try Right Size before you buy it. Just pay shipping and handling. Call 1-800-318-9085.
Goodbye, Jordan. beer starts out this cold, it ends up this refreshing. Coors Light.
Legend number 35, Dallas Elliott. From the Colorado Mammoth, number 6, Dan Terry. From the Arizona Sting, number 7, Scott Self. From the Calgary Roughnecks, the fastest gun in the West, number 9, from the San Jose Stealth, number 18, Derek Malotsky. From the Arizona Sting, the Desert Rat, number 20, Bruce Todd. From the Arizona Sting, number 27, Peter Locke. From the Calgary Roughnecks, the Minister of Defense, number 40, Taylor.
I think so.
colleague that has just been inducted to the NLL Hall of Fame. Please welcome number 22, Gary Gates. At this time, with West Captain Peter Locke and East Captain Jim Sue-Beltman at the center.
Versus West. We'll show you who's best next.
We are the men and women of the United States Army Reserve. We are regular people who share our time serving our country and our communities. Our training makes us stronger as soldiers and as citizens. Stand ready.
To find out how you can serve your country in the Army Reserve, call 1-888-624-ARMY for this free DVD and get a free sports watch. Stand ready in the Army Reserve.
Do chaser hangover pills really work? It's an important question, especially if you're one of the millions who suffer a hangover after moderate social drinking. The answer is in how Chaser works. Just take two Chaser caplets with your first drink and two more later. Chaser is made of specially processed calcium carbonate and charcoal. These ingredients absorb toxins and acids, then pass them out of your system, kind of like a filter. The next morning, you'll wake up feeling great. And here's proof. In clinical trials, Chaser reduced hangover symptoms as much as 70% over placebo. 70%. Pain relievers only dull the agony once you have a hangover, and they carry serious alcohol warnings. But Chaser helps stop hangovers before they start. That's it. The simple facts behind Chaser. It absorbs toxins, then passes them from your system. Take it while you drink to help you wake up feeling great. Find out if Chaser's right for you. Chaser products are available at these fine stores. Or for more information, go to chaseronline.com.
The National Lacrosse League on Rogers Sportsnet. Brought to you by Future Shop and Toshiba. Proud sponsors of the 2006 National Lacrosse League. And by Molson Canadian. For true Canadian taste from Canada's oldest brewery, it starts here.
Welcome back to the Air Canada Centre for the 2006 National Lacrosse League All-Star Contest. The third member of our broadcast crew is Sam Cosentino, and he is a special guest. Sam?
Thanks very much, Peter. With Ed Como, the head coach of the Rochester Nighthawks, your team off to a 5-3 first half. Four players in this game, but maybe none more dynamic than John Grant Jr. What can we expect from him here today?
Well, I mean, John's an awesome player, but shooting the ball real well, going hard to the net. So I would expect all-star game. He's going to do all that, and I'm sure he's got a few tricks up his sleeve, too.
Now, I saw you request the whiteboard to do some coaching here in this game. There can't be a whole lot of coaching going on in an all-star game.
No, it's more watching, but, you know, when we have some timeouts, we might as well have some fun with it and do some different things. So we're going to have some fun and play hard.
Thanks, Eddie. Good luck.
Thanks, sir.
Ed Como, head coach of the Rochester Nighthawks.
The East trying to beat the West for the third consecutive year. Our starting goaltenders today are brought to you by Molson Canadian. And we begin with a former member of the Toronto Rock, now of the San Jose Stealth. He's the 28-year-old from Mississauga, Ontario, Anthony Cosmo, with the league's second best goals against average. And at the other end, oh, he's been around for quite some time in his fourth All-Star appearance. A member of the Rochester Nighthawks, Pat O'Toole. He's a 34-year-old from right here in Toronto. Our officials are Tom Sutton, Grant Spees, and Scott Molloy. An exciting game, Brian Shanahan, 1 year ago in Calgary when the East won it on John Tavares' overtime winner by a count of 11-10. We hope for more of the same here today.
Absolutely, Peter. These guys play these all-star games, full contact, lots of hitting, you can expect.
And it looks like the approach is good in the opening seconds as Jage Albert loses control, and then the ball turns over to the Stars of the Eastern Conference. And immediately it belongs to John Tavares, 1,091 points in his career. He'll send it in and go to the bench. The Eastern Conference looked to strike first, and behind his back is John Grant. And then he plays it off the end glass. Oh, we will see a few tricks today. Scott Self in transition for the West. He dishes off for Sharp. One of the fine defenders in the league, to his Colorado teammate Gavin Prout, who could not accept the pass. Back come the East. Mark Steenhuis between his legs. The rebound scores. And the East strike first, courtesy of Minnesota Swarm's Ryan Cousins.
Did you see that shot by Mark Steenhuis? Let's watch this replay. Between the legs, yes. I thought he did that. He called it. Oh my gosh. Original shot couldn't go in. Cousins picks up that rebound. Puts a pass, Cosmo.
Ryan Cousins opens the scoring. He scored a goal in last year's game. And it's quick to get the Eastern Conference stars on the board. And Steenhuis with a little evidence as to why he scored six goals in the 2004 encounter and was the game's MVP.
And already these teams have shown us they don't mind a few trick shots. John Grant put the one off the backboards, and Steenhuis's trick shot.
Not hard to find the speedy Steenhuis with the orange shoes, and they're bright, but he is stripped of the ball by a great rookie named Brody Merrill. He was the number one overall pick in the 2005 National Lacrosse League draft. The West on the attack. Going to the front of the net is Arizona Sting's Craig Kahn. And Kahn with 22 goals already in just six games for the Sting. One of the up-and-coming budding superstars in indoor lacrosse. Here's Jake Bergey of the Philadelphia Wings driving the net, but Cam Bergman knocked it away from him. A member of the Edmonton Rush, and he is lightning fast, number 61. Gavin Prout. He drops it off for his Colorado teammate. Now it goes cross floor from Lewis Ratcliffe for the Calgary Roughnecks, wearing number 42. Terry in front, taken away, but Ratcliffe has a chance, and there's the first save of the game for the veteran netminder Pat O'Toole. Phil Sanderson with Steenhuis running the floor. Pulling it back out is Colin Doyle. He's second in the National Lacrosse League in points with 55. His Toronto teammate, number 19, Josh Sanderson. Look at Steenhuis. Between his legs twice. Phil Sanderson plays it for Steenhuis. Threw an assist on the goal. Behind his back is the 30-second time clock. It expires, and you only have 30 seconds on each offensive possession to register a shot on goal if you're brand new to lacrosse. Lewis Ratcliffe for the Calgary Roughnecks enjoying another fine campaign. Ratcliffe holding a nifty little step, but the defender closed the gap well. And Jim Veltman trying to scoop up a loose ball, and no one does it better in the league than that. It's a little contact involving Prout and Veltman. Our keys to the game, and we will begin with the Eastern Conference, are brought to you by Future Shop and Toshiba. They are proud sponsors of the 2006 National Lacrosse League All-Star Game.
It's difficult coming up with the keys to the game for an All-Star game. A lot of guys getting used to each other, but the East is going to have to control the loose balls. They've got a lot of great guys in offense if they get the ball to them.
Played some pretty good defense in the early going. Cousins, who has the goal for John Grant behind his back. Tall Grant!
Passing play on this one. 3-on-2. Watch this pass by Grant over to Toll and back. These two play together in Rochester. Looks like something they've done in practice. A reverse over-the-shoulder pass. Grant to Toll and right back.
John Grant showing you why he is the leader in goals in the National Lacrosse League with 32 in his first eight games. Number 24 scored a career-high 52 times for Rochester back in the 2002 season. He is just a treat to watch. On display in a game like this. Scott Self goes coast to coast. There's the best chance for the Western Conference, who trail early 2-0. Steenhuis of the Buffalo Bandits. He's more concerned about going behind his back today, it would appear. And does it pretty well. Finds a trailer, and Grant with that bullet-like drive did not miss his second of the day by much. He was the hardest shooter in last night's skills competition at 161 kilometers an hour, or for those of you in the United States, that's just over 100 miles an hour. Danny Merrill of the Philadelphia Wings takes a whack from Jalbert. Jalbert of Colorado, he's never afraid to get involved. A tough defender and a former two-time All-American at the University of Virginia.
Jalbert is one of the reasons these teams play it so hard. A couple of years ago, the game started off as a no-hitter until Jalbert creamed Glenn Clark, and the game was on from that point on, and they haven't looked back at an All-Star game.
Dan Carey joins the attack. The star at Canisius College lets it go, and it nearly found the hole between the legs of Pat O'Toole. Mark Steenhuis, an all-star from the Buffalo Bandits, putting on a show.
Hoo-yah! Go Daddy, the world's number one in domain name.
Bang, bang, banana pants with a lazy baby bingo.
Makes it fast, fun, and affordable to get on the internet.
Oh, I'm getting shaky, my baby.
We get Dario.com.
For just $3.99.
Right now, when you buy any of GoDaddy's hot internet products, you get your .com or any other domain for just $3.99. $3.99.com's at GoDaddy.com. Just go to www.GoDaddy.com/TV.
It's GoDaddy!
Snow is a beautiful thing. And when you can dash through it without worry, safety is a beautiful thing, too. The Volvo XC90 SUV and the all-wheel drive Volvo XC70 cross country. For a limited time, we're making the XC90 and XC70 even more attractive.
Lease a Volvo XC70 for $379 a month for 36 months.
Get the latest lowdown on your favorite team with Altitude's Avalanche Alert. From Lunch with Mike to Avs Extra, you'll see your favorite players shine in a whole new light.
It's a French game.
So get in the game and get caught up on your Avs with Avalanche Alert.
We might have played one of our best games of the year against Dallas. Our play was on fire.
Check out new episodes every Wednesday at 6, presented by Stevenson Lexus, saluting 10 years of Colorado's pursuit of perfection.
This quarter, brought to you by Yamaha, the most reliable ATVs on the planet, and by Lacrosse TV, the only place to watch 24/7 lacrosse action.
Well, Peter, it might seem obvious, but the key for the West could be to control John Grant, John Tavares, and Colin Doyle, and so far, they haven't done a great job on Johnny Grant scoring that beautiful goal.
Just three of the finest to ever play. Other than that, it's easy. Here's Sam Cosentino.
Thanks, Peter. With John Grant Jr. now, and just almost 6 minutes into this game, doesn't look like you're having any fun out there.
Oh, it's a lot tougher game than people might think. It's an all-star game, but we really want to win. They want to win, so it's going to be a good game.
We've seen a couple of tricks so far. These guys don't have any spies watching in the dressing room right now. Is there any trick that we can expect from yourself later on in the game?
Oh, we might have some fun things to do. It depends on the score, and if it's the right time, we might do some stuff.
Thanks, John. That's the NLL's leading goal scorer, John Grant Jr.
And he has a goal already today for the Eastern Conference on a wonderful give and go with his Rochester Nighthawk teammate, Steve Toll. Jake Bergey scored a pair of goals last night in this building for Philadelphia, and what was just a wonderful game of lacrosse. A loss to Toronto in overtime. Veltman jumps into the rush. Look at Eddie Como with an extra attacker as we go 2-0 the other way. Ryan Sharp fired it wide. So you take a chance at one end and lose the battle in transition at the other.
That's Eddie Como's game when he was with the Toronto Rock. They used to do that a lot. Pull the goaltender when you're playing 5-on-5. Hopefully catch the other team not paying attention. Get a man open for a shot. That time it didn't work.
Scott Sell for the Arizona Sting. Plays it. Here's an opportunity for Jalbert. Known for his defensive work, but he's no stranger to chipping in offensively. Neither is Mark Steenhuis. Steenhuis with an assist already in the game. Controlling. Pestered by Cam Bergman. I'd know that stride anywhere from watching him this season with the Edmonton Rush. He is lightning quick, and there he goes on the rush without the ball. Brody Merrill of the Portland Lumberjacks, cross floor, moving in. Prout trying to get a shot away. Of the Colorado Mammoth, Bergman, that hit the pipe. Cam Bergman set up well, and Pat O'Toole with some help from his best buddy.
It's a pretty good transition coming from the defensive end on the Western team, including Cam Bergman and Brody Merrill. Those guys both like to move the ball up quickly, and they can put it in the net when they have a chance.
Merrill tied for the lead amongst defensemen in scoring. 17 points along with Steve Toll of Rochester performing for the Eastern Conference. And guess who has the ball? Toll, and he can fly too. He plays it off the return feed, and Anthony Cosmo with a terrific left shoulder save off Stevie Toll. Todd, his pass too hot to handle for Craig Kahn of the Arizona Sting. Daryl Gibson of the Minnesota Swarm playing in the game for Marshall Abrams of Philadelphia, who could not participate because of an injury. Cousins leaves it for Blaine Manning. Manning one-handed in front. Peter Locke, the captain of this team and captain in Arizona, broke it up. He had four assists in the game, Locke did last year. Self for Jonas Dirks, also of the Arizona Sting. They have five players in this game. Radcliffe, and now Eric Molaski of the San Jose Stealth. He leads Radcliffe. Caleb Toth. That was something that O'Toole had to be careful with. It was a pass, but it ended up as a shot.
I think he was trying to feed it behind the net. O'Toole picked it off easily.
Here's Thomas Hayek, the captain of the Philadelphia Wings. The starter on defense for this Eastern Conference team. Josh Sanderson, what a year he's enjoyed. Leads the league in scoring with 58 points, four more last night in the win over Philadelphia. For the Toronto Rock, a Toronto Rock member, Colin Doyle behind his back as the shot clock just about to expire. Brody Merrill, his pass just a little bit too high for the wide open Craig Kahn. And you'll notice those types of situations, players not accustomed to playing with one another. Jake Burton, 17 goals on the season. John Tavares, so dangerous. But Cosmo had a good look and a good deep
nice pass.
Who will take it? Jalbert, O'Toole, but he can't stop Sharp. And the Western Conference is on the board, courtesy of a Portland Lumberjack, Ryan Sharp.
Absolutely beautiful pass by Anthony Cosmo. Throws it up ahead of his team, knowing they're going to run into it. Jalbert picked up the ball. Original save by O'Toole, but Ryan Sharp, second year in the NLL, puts one in his first All-Star game.
Makes no mistake, Sharp with six goals so far on the season. Dan Carey in front. Thanks for the opportunity for Gavin Prout, who knows how to find the back of the net. Ryan Cousins with a loose ball, and he's off to a wonderful start. Member of the Minnesota Storm with a goal and an assist. Buffalo's Steenhuis, seven career goals in a couple of All-Star games, but he's upended on this account. Pass for Bergman misses, and wholesale changes coming up for the Western Conference on the board, courtesy of the goal from Brian Sharp, Jalbert, and Cosmo, the goaltender, with the other assist. On the floor, Danny Merrill. Farrell of the Philadelphia Wings. Good pass. John Grant one-handed. Not sure if that was a pass or a shot. How would you know? Wayne Manning spilled. Hey, there's a little all-star fun for you. Just to show you that they care and have come to play. Lewis Ratcliffe, 19 goals for the Calgary Roughnecks. Hahn, and now he plays it for Dierks. O'Toole with the save, and Toll's wide open. His Rochester teammate, Stevie Toll, that got a piece of the pipe. And Cosmo with a piece as well. Great save off Toll. Toll was a leader in goals in the 2002 All-Star game with three. Ratcliffe shot. Ouch, that hit Gibson. And back comes the speedy Steenhuis. By himself. What a move! Cosmo. An even better save. Steenhuis with it one more time. He's like a little jukebox. Manning, he scores! Wayne Manning of the Toronto Rocks, first of the day. And it's 3-1 for the Eastern Conference.
Manning is so good at changing his angle the last second. We talked about this in the Toronto-Philadelphia game yesterday where he scored a couple of goals. When the goalie thinks he has the angle blocked, he stretches his stick a little bit just to change that angle a bit. They get a little more net to shoot at.
Lane Manning from Sherwood Park, Alberta, coming off an 8-point performance last night in the Rocks' victory over Philadelphia. Enjoyed a 10-point game this season against Edmonton back on January the 27th. Blaine Manning has restored the Eastern Conference's two-goal advantage.
For years I saved for college, then debt just wiped us out, and he might not be able to go.
Our retirement funds drained, and we got scared. We use credit cards too much, and now I don't know what we'll do.
Behind on bills, living from paycheck to paycheck? Get out of debt now with free financial counseling from a nonprofit company called Genesis. Call 1-800-709-4409, 1-800-709-4409.
We may not have a cent to pay the rent.
It's a sound that came from down south.
Got to get you off of my mind.
Time Life Music proudly presents Down Home Soul.
Don't play that song for me.
Aretha Franklin.
Cause it brings back memories.
Al Green.
I'm so tired of being alone. I'm so tired.
Clarence Carter.
Slip away.
Get Down Home Soul on two CDs for just $19.99. But wait.
Don't hold it.
Order with your credit card and we'll cut the price in half. Then preview other great soul collections. Satisfaction guarantee. That's two CDs for just $9.99.
Call 1-800-414-0606 to order Down Home Soul for $9.99 plus shipping and handling when you use your credit card. Call now or order online at timelife.com.
This quarter brought to you by Yamaha, the most reliable ATVs on the planet, and by Lacrosse TV, the only place to watch 24/7 lacrosse action.
The youngsters enjoying themselves, and they'll enjoy this. The Future Shop National Lacrosse League Game of the Week, presented by Toshiba, coming up on Friday when the Minnesota Swarm visit the Toronto Rock. There's your time, 7:30 Eastern on Sportsnet East and on Sportsnet Ontario, as we're joined once again by Sam Cosentino.
Thanks, Peter. With Brody Merrill now, and talk about your first experience here in an All-Star game.
Oh, it's amazing. You're growing up in the Toronto area and playing, get a chance to play in the ACC tonight. It's really a dream come true, and a great atmosphere in here. I'm having a lot of fun.
Your brother Patrick plays for the Toronto Rock. What have you learned from him in adjusting to the National Lacrosse League?
Well, you know, I've followed his career. I've been pretty close with him and his teammates, since he's been in the league. And, you know, I just love watching him play. I just learned from watching him play. That's right. Two hands on loose balls. That's right, Caleb. But yeah, I mean, it's great to just come in here. We got a chance to watch a game last night, and it was, you know, an atmosphere I haven't really seen live before, and it was pretty special.
Continued success.
Thanks a lot.
That's Brody Merrill when he's not playing lacrosse, guys. He's a high school teacher in Oregon.
Thank you very much, Sam. And he's going to be playing this game at a high level for a long time, Mr. Shanahan. I think that's pretty evident the way he's started his National Lacrosse League career.
I've already noticed some guys are careful when they're running near him. He's very dangerous with the stick check. He already stripped the ball off Mark Steenhuis once. Watch for that.
An NCAA college star at Georgetown University, a two-time Player of the Year finalist. Jonas Dirk spins. What an opportunity and what a finish for Lewis Radcliffe behind his back to make it 3-2.
Well, Lewis Radcliffe was the leading scorer of Calgary last year and among the leaders this year again, and he can finish. And where do you see this rebound? He's going to... Nice shot by Jonas Dirks, but Radcliffe comes in and just does a spinorama play. And he's always dangerous around the net. That's impossible for a goalie to stop. If that hits the net, great goal.
Radcliffe showing you why he is sixth in scoring in the National Lacrosse League. With those 19 goals, marks the second consecutive All-Star game that Lewis Radcliffe has scored a goal in. He's played in several of these games, foiled by goaltender O'Toole, and another great chance, and that might have got a piece of the iron. A one-handed scoop shot, and we are tied at 3.
Well, the West is turning it on. Derek Malowski had a few good chances here, but it was the rookie and the only rookie in the game, Dan Carey from Peterborough, Ontario, who ends up showing you why he was picked to play in this All-Star game. Watch this one. Nice shot. Underhand. One-handed underhand shot. West is putting the pressure on.
Dan Carey has 8 goals this season. His rookie campaign with the Colorado Mammoth, he was the 7th player selected overall in the 2005 draft. Radcliffe, what a move past Steenhuis, and O'Toole, what a fine save. Long outlet for Ryan Cousins of Minnesota, already has a goal and an assist in the game. Late stages of the first quarter, the West has bounced back. What a rocket from Sean Williams of the Rochester Nighthawks. He's always in that elite group of scorers in the league. J.J. Albert in front scores. Jonas Dirks, and then he salutes some of his fans in row 4 or 5, or who knows, maybe 10. But it's 4-3 for the Western Conference.
Nifty little play by Dirks, who is just on the edge of the crease, waiting for the pass, sneaking in there. Watch him lean over there. Beautiful. Keeps his feet out of the crease. Just see how he sneaks behind the defender, Jimmy Veltman.
Jonas Dirks has 13 goals this season in 6 games for the Arizona Sting. And is on the board in this All-Star contest as the West has come back from a early 3-1 deficit. Look at this battle for a loose ball. Thomas Hayek scores! And poor Anthony Cosmo, the only thing that didn't end up behind the net was him.
Captain of the Philadelphia Wings. Had a great game last night, a losing cause of the Toronto Rock. Benefits on a nice loose ball, just the right spot, the right time. But watch Cosmo. A desperate throw, desperately throwing up his stick.
Defender.
Oh, that was a nice shot. He just drills this. You're going to see this here. Just drills it in that top corner. Beautiful goal to Dan Carey. Second of the game for the rookie.
Carey led Canisius, his university team, in scoring in 2005 with 30 goals and has is his second goal of this All-Star contest, his first. He's just a rookie. The first of many, by the looks of things, from that player out of Peterborough, Ontario, a member of the Colorado Mammoth. We have a few goals today. I think that's fairly apparent. The shot from John Grant. Stopped by Cosmo. Long lead pass, and Grant back defensively. Can he control it? No. But his Eastern Conference mates can. Danny Merrill! Sanderson, maybe one extra move. Strip. There's a good defensive play from Brody Merrill.
Dangerous with that stick. He uses a long stick to feel across. Sometimes looks like he has a long stick out here.
Here he is at the other end, feeding it for Bruce Codd. And he stopped as the first quarter comes to a conclusion, with the Western Conference Stars coming back to take a 5-4 lead.
Favorite 1-5, this is Bobcat 3-6 from Weapons and Enemy Camp. Orders for head back as follows. Ridge, Echo, Hotel, over. Overwatch, Overwatch. This is Hope 2, Institution, over.
Jason from California.
Kathy, Michigan.
Today, thousands of people will go to progressive.com, where they'll get their quote for car insurance and see what other people have been quoted as well. Whether Progressive is the highest or the lowest, you'll see it all. Go to progressive.com, because the more you know, the easier it is to make a smart decision.
With play online at partypoker.com, the world's largest poker room. More players, more tables, more winners. Sign up now. Use the code WOOF for a special bonus.
All right, okay.
The 2005 President's Cup champions are back. Reigning MVP Greg Pankowitz leads the first-place Colorado Eagles on a quest for their second consecutive title. Watch your Colorado Eagles make history this year, only on Altitude Sports and Entertainment. Ryan Tobler and your Colorado Eagles fight for more breathing room in the Northwest, facing off against the second-place Oklahoma City Blazers. That's Blazers-Eagles, tonight at 7, only on Altitude.
This quarter brought to you by Vonage, the broadband phone company, and by Lacrosse TV, the only place to watch 24/7 lacrosse action.
Here is what's next for the Toronto Rock. Of course, they play their home games right in this building. Minnesota, March the 3rd. Calgary, an afternoon game on the 25th. And April 8th versus Philadelphia. If it's anything like the first home game against Philadelphia, I know who will be in attendance for that. And you should be, too. There is the number, Ticketmaster.com. And, of course, you can catch every Rock home game right here on Rogers Sportsnet. Some stats to show you from the first quarter of action.
Well, the score is 5-4, shots even, but look at the loose balls, 23-23. A lot of ground balls for one quarter, and that just shows that they're willing to make a lot of passes, take a lot of chances.
Gavin Prout was 6 of the 23 for the Western Conference. He's the all-time leader in loose balls in all-star games. He's in his fourth. He now has 33 all-time at 27 coming in. Here's a member of the Mammoth, and there's Prout as well behind his back. Excellent stop by O'Toole. Now it's Dirks. My goodness, another chance, and O'Toole putting on a show. Great saves by the veteran 34-year-old netminder of the Rochester Knights. more time. He's got a good shot. Cosmo scoops it before John Grant could and plays it quickly for Colorado's Gavin Prout. Waiting for the other attackers to come out on the floor. The Western Conference trailed this game at 1.3-1 in the first quarter. Have gone ahead. Lewis Ratcliffe with a goal. Bothered by Steenhuus. Caleb Toth for the Calgary Roughnecks. No chance. Hayek and Prout in a good battle. And Veltman with another loose ball. Has 129 of those this season, does the 39-year-old veteran Jim Veltman of the Toronto Rock. Josh Sanderson of the Toronto Rock intercepted by Peter Locke of the Arizona Sting. And Bob Hamley on the conference call for this game the other day just could not say enough glowing things about his captain in Arizona. The 31-year-old from New Westminster, British Columbia. Taylor Ray, look out in row 12. Taylor Ray's beginning to his National Lacrosse League career wasn't bad, Brian, in 2004.
Absolutely, Rookie of the Year and Co-Defensive Player of the Year. Last year he suffered a knee injury, came back, wasn't 100%, but he looks like he's back to form this season, playing in his first All-Star game for the National Lacrosse League.
You take a look at him, he's a specimen, too. Well put together. A near miss. Scott Self has some room to operate.
Oh.
Accepted by Colin Doyle, and then he'll play it ahead for Hayek. And Bruce Codd races back to break it up. That's a nice defensive play by Bruce Codd of the Arizona Sting from one of those lacrosse hotbeds in Canada, Orangeville, Ontario. Steenhuis with Colin Doyle. Bergman one-on-one versus Steenhuis. Behind his back, what a pass, Manning! And a better stop by Cosmo. Off of the man they call the Prairie Dog. Steenhuis a drive. Kicked away by Cosmo, who's really performing admirably. Steenhuis is pulled down, no penalty. Or is there? Yes, the back official says yes, so we are going to have a power play opportunity.
See too many penalties in the All-Star game, but the East is going to go to the power play. And this should be interesting with the likes of John Grant, Colin Doyle, Josh Sanderson, John Tavares. Who do you put on the power play?
Probably all of them. It'll be fun to watch. There's no question about that. And Grant to start it. Steenhuis out there. So is Doyle. So is Tavares. And it's intercepted by Bruce Codd, who just seems to be everywhere in this game. The member of the Arizona Sting. Behind his back is Brody Merrill. As the Eastern Conference trailing, but find themselves on the power play. Tavares dishes off. Manning a rocket. Missed. Taylor Ray, how about that play to clear the ball out of harm's way for Jalbert? Short-handed, in front, and a nice save off Brody Merrill by Pat O'Toole. Bruce Codd with a loose ball. He's running off some penalty time. Feeds it for Jonas Dirks. Dirks of the Arizona Sting has a goal from Whitby, Ontario. Here's Ratcliffe in front. Oh, what an play to just take that pass in by Miloski. Impressive. Jake Bergey, Ryan Cousins joins him. John Grant out there as well. Now Grant will make his way to the bench. Sean Williams. I'm sure that's about to change. Might get one right here. And you know what? He just did.
You called it. Nice pass from Williams to Veltman, but what a beautiful pass. Veltman to Bergey. And I bet Bergey feels better about that one tonight than he does about Veltman's pass for the winning goal yesterday in overtime against Bergey's team, the Philadelphia Wings. Now Bergey knows how Aaron Wilson felt yesterday.
Bergey had an unbelievable fourth quarter yesterday for Philadelphia, scoring two of his his 17 goals on the year. He's tied the game with a power play goal. That's his second ever All-Star goal. He'll find a man wide open in front. It's Carey. Oh. How did that stay out? It did. Carey foiled on a hat trick attempt. The East is tied it. I'm Jake Bergey's power play goal.
What are you setting your sights on? And when you see it, will you be ready? Just pick up the phone, dial 1-800-645-ARMY, and you'll get this free DVD. You'll learn about the hundreds of opportunities the Army can offer you. Skills, education, healthcare. Call 1-800-645-ARMY, and you'll also get this free boonie hat. Whatever you're looking for, the Army can help you find it.
Between my two phone bills, it's probably about $60 a month.
About $150.
Probably $100 bucks a month.
With Vonage, you get unlimited calls to anywhere in the U.S. and Canada, and all the cool features you could ever want are included. And it's just $24.99 a month. Call 1-800-972-4866 and get your first month free. This offer is also available online and at these fine retailers. Vonage, leading the internet phone revolution.
Yeah, I'm trying to add a new car to my policy online, and I...
No, that's not possible.
Oh, you don't do that.
No, maybe.
Can I pay my bill online?
No,
you don't do that either?
No, sorry, can't do that.
You don't do that? Okay, so what do you do?
Hey, think easier. Think Progressive. Our top-rated website lets you do virtually everything with your policy, easily and instantly. Check out Progressive.com.
It's a 16-game season in the National Lacrosse League, so basically at the halfway point for many teams, not all. Rochester in the lead, but Buffalo has only played six games, and then you see the battle, and it's every bit as tight out west with Colorado and Calgary, and outside of the expansion, Edmonton Rush, they're all right in the hunt as we send it down to Sam Cosentino.
Thanks, Peter. With Mark Stainos of the Buffalo Bandits, and much like your shoes, your game has a lot of flash and dash, but you still look like you're out there competing hard to win this game for the East.
Well, yeah, we kind of came out, and I mean, it's an all-star game, so everyone's having fun. As you can see behind me, these guys, everybody's enjoying themselves. So I know the West came out, and they had something to prove, so we got to kind of step our game up and play with the guys.
A couple of good tricks so far. Is there anything else in that bag of tricks we can expect later in the game?
Yeah, I think there's a few more things in there. I might have to pull them out.
Thanks for your time.
No problem.
Peter?
Thanks, Sam. The 25-year-old from St. Catharines, Ontario, in his third All-Star appearance. Steenhuis was the MVP of the 2004 All-Star Classic. Scored six goals in that game, and that's a record in All-Star contests in this National Lacrosse League. That's a couple of assists.
He won over the opposing fans. That game was played in the West.
And a possession change to the Eastern Conference. O'Toole for Jim Veltman. He'll try and run it down. Taps it away from Sharp. Williams helps up with his first ever All-Star point. Williams on the goal that tied it by Bergey on the power play. Taylor Ray for J.J. Albert of Colorado. And Koleski, you've got to be kidding me. The bag of tricks of Tracy Koleski. Can't wait to see that again.
Absolutely. I've never seen him put on this move. Koleski never came back. He hung up the floor the whole time there. Oh, my.
He just, like, dropped it off.
Yep. Just left it. Just left it there as he was coming across.
Well, he's known to have some of the best hands and greatest skills in all of the National Lacrosse League. And I haven't seen that one before.
And I've probably seen him play about 100 times in this league. And I haven't seen this move yet.
You have now. 17 goals on the year for Tracy Koleski of the Calgary Roughnecks. You know what? I was going to ask you where he's been the first little while in this game because he's such an impact player. And the ball just hasn't been on his stick a lot. So he decides when it was, let us all notice.
I think Pat O'Toole was a little bit annoyed at it too. Pat O'Toole was making the pass up the floor a little bit earlier after Jim Veltman. Koleski put a little interference on him. I think if it was a regular season game, there was a good chance that would have been a penalty call for interference on the goalie, but they're not calling it so tight so far. But I think O'Toole was a little annoyed at that.
Yeah, that's good. That'll just drive the competition of the game. I'm all for it. So far as the 6-5 score in favor of the West would indicate. The buzzer goes, but play continues because the possession had already changed from West to East.
You know what? That was Cam Bergman coming back there. You think we can get Cam Bergman and Steve Toll to have a race down there? Because Steve Toll has always been the fastest in the league, and I'm not so sure Cam Bergman might be the new fastest in the league.
Well, I watched yourself and Mr. Millions call the Edmonton-Toronto game a couple of weeks ago, and it just seemed like every time you turned around, Bergman was racing all alone by himself. John Tavares. His pass, he receives it back, tries to drop it for Manning, or make that Cousins. And maybe one extra pass that time from Tavares, who one of the leaders all time in all categories, including all-star game points. Tavares has 17. He's one shy of the all-time lead of 18, held by a former Philadelphia wing, Paul Cantabine, who has 18. Phil Sanderson behind his back to Glenn Clark. And he scores to tie it again.
Glenn Clark, longtime Toronto Rock player, 5 championships with Toronto. Signed in Philadelphia as a free agent, was back here last night. And that one's got to feel good for him. Playing defense mostly, but on the offense on that one.
Glenn Clark making his third consecutive All-Star appearance. First as a member of the Philadelphia Wings.
Glenn Clark was picked as a starter in last year's All-Star game in Calgary.
On lead pass. Colin Doyle foiled by someone who's seen a few of his tricks. Anthony Cosby. Too many of them probably in his Rock practice days. Prout, his pass, hit a stick. Back to Gavin Prout of Colorado. Kahn intercepted. Oh, nice. Great defensive play. Steenhuis has a breakaway. Mark Steenhuis by himself. No siree. Cosmo thought he stepped in the crease, too. Steenhuis himself. Steenhuis waits for reinforcements. Veltman quickly. Down low, Williams.
Oh, I thought he put that in for a second. He would have hit the back of the net.
Terrific ball movement by the East. Scott Self of the Arizona Sting. He's a youngster, relatively speaking, at 26. Caleb Toth, the Calgary Roughnecks. What a move by Radcliffe. Off the shoulder. And back they come in the other direction. trying to collect another loose ball, and he's used to that. Boy, I was so impressed with his performance one night ago against Philadelphia for the Toronto Rock. He was involved in so many of these types of situations, coming away with the loose ball. That time, it belongs to Jay Jalbert. Jalbert, nice move on Ryan Cousins behind his back from the Colorado Mammoth player.
Oh,
almost a gift in front that time for Koleski. He gave us a gift with his goal in this second quarter. Bill Sanderson misses Bergey, and it belongs to Ryan Sharp. Taylor Ray drew an assist on an earlier goal by his Calgary teammate Koleski. Craig Kahn, 22 goals on the season for Arizona. Loose in front. There was a good opportunity, but no siree for Derek Malosky. Glenn Clark's first of this game is tied it at 6.
This was my prom, my spring break, road trip with friends, summer camp, semester abroad, Thanksgiving. What do you call a life dedicated to hockey? I'd call it time well spent.
The Denver Nuggets are on Altitude Sports and Entertainment. Boykins, Miller, and your Denver Nuggets head home to Pepsi Center, where they push for a season sweep against Michael Redd and the Bucks. Bucks Nuggets. The coverage begins Monday at 6:30, only on Altitude.
Every week, Altitude hits the streets of Denver seeking out the local hotspots you want to know about. Join Kyle Keefe around the town as he checks out Denver's favorite festivals, theaters, sporting events, restaurants, shops, and more. Plus, we sit down with Hollywood's hottest stars and go behind the scenes of their latest movies. There's never a dull moment around the town. Wednesday at 5 on Altitude.
You're watching Altitude Sports and Entertainment.
Mark your calendar for Sunday, April 2nd for the annual Avs Better Halves Charity Brunch and Fashion Show at the new Hyatt Regency Convention Center Hotel. This heartwarming event features Avs players, coaches, and Better Halves, as well as special ambassadors from the Children's Hospital in a special fashion show by Neiman Marcus. This is your opportunity to see the players in different roles, all to support Colorado Children's Charities, including the Children's Hospital. For ticket information, visit ColoradoAvalanche.com.
It's the fastest growing winter sport on the planet. Chock full of action. Goals. And full speed fun. It's sled hockey. And teams are forming right now all across the country. Visit one of these websites and sign up to play sled hockey today. Get into the action. Get in on the fun. Sled hockey.
This quarter brought to you by Vonage, the broadband phone company. And by Lacrosse TV, the only place to watch 24/7 lacrosse action.
3:49 left in the first half. We're all tied at 6 here in the National Lacrosse League All-Star Game. I'm joined by Tracy Koleski now, and your goal looking awful lot like Jussi Jokinen of the Dallas Stars, just kind of leaving it behind there. Any inspiration at all from the NHL?
A little bit, yeah, definitely. We're watching those guys. We're always, innovators, creators, and just drop it in there.
This is your fourth All-Star game, and seemingly everyone has gotten better.
Yeah, definitely. The fans here are awesome in Toronto, and I think the game itself, it's going to pick up here. It's picking up gradually as we get going here, and I think the second half is going to be really exciting.
Continued success.
Thank you.
That's Tracy Kaleski, tied for ninth in the National Lacrosse League with 36 points.
Thank you, Sam, and that's his second All-Star game goal. One goal and eight assists for 9 points in his previous three contests.
Last year he was the All-Star Game MVP, as voted by the fans.
Game played in Calgary. He had a goal and three assists. Blaine Manning has a goal today. Vershawn Williams broken up in front neatly, and the ball belongs to Taylor Ray. Ray played collegiate lacrosse at Duke University. He was a Blue Devil, and he has a goal, too. A fortunate carom for the Calgary Roughneck defender, and he beats Pat O'Toole to make it 7-6 for the West.
Taylor Ray could put the ball in the net as a rookie. He scored 8 goals, 8 assists. And he's like a running back when he moves up the floor, but this time he was just at the right spot, got a fortunate bounce, but nice shot.
Taylor Ray has 5 goals this season for the Calgary Roughnecks. Defensive play. Sean Williams in transition of Rochester Williams. He scores, showing you why he's always been one of the premier scorers in recent years in this league.
And both you and I were shocked when we saw that he had no points in his first two All-Star games, but you called it right when you said that was going to change. And Sean Williams shows some good finish, reaches for the far side, goes short. That's very tough for a goalie to stop when you can move your hands as quick as Sean Williams can.
And Williams with 42 points already this season. That's fifth in the league. And has a goal and an assist today. Gavin Krug. Nice passing. Missing rack left and belongs to Derek Velosky. Krug. Misses Molaski this time. Caroms to Phil Sanderson. What a pass! Behind his back for Daryl Gibson of Minnesota. Gibson, Steenhuis, stuck by Cosmo, and the bar two. You know, that net is so compact, and it comes out so quickly. Sometimes from this angle, difficult to tell if it hits the pipe or
his shin guard. That was hard to tell whether it was a pipe or his leg. I think it was Cosmo's leg.
Out of the net, it stayed. At any rate, here's a long outlet. Stevie Toll. Cosmo stayed with. That was Danny Merrill. That's a 2, not a 1 and a 7. Merrill behind his back of the Philadelphia Wings. Their leading scorer. Cosmo with some great work. Sharp. Terry Dirk.
Oh, my gosh.
Great save, O'Toole. On the three-way passing play. Veltman, how about that feed? Tavares! Diving in! Anthony Cosmo, second best average in the league in goal. Member of the San Jose Stealth. The last few minutes, he's been fabulous. Taylor Ray. In behind the net now for Kaleski. Back in front, Molaski bats at it. No, O'Toole stopped it. Just over a minute to go, and what's been an entertaining first half. This is Steve Toll, trying to beat his former Toronto teammate, Anthony Cosmo, with yet another save. Jake Albert, he's been the leader offensively in this game, Brian. He already has 4 assists. Plays with Colorado. Dirk's a little trouble. Now he'll collect it. I think he will. Yes, he will. Shot clock running down. A rocket from Dirk's. It's not bad in terms of breakaway creativity, as we saw last night in the skills competition. Reset to 30 and likely the last possession of the half.
A lot of these players have two tricky plays that they're not going to pull too often in a regular game, but they're not afraid to try it out here.
Timeout has been called. by the Eastern Conference as Ryan Cousins of Minnesota jumps on the loose ball with 25.7 seconds left in the half. Here's a little history for you. The format has changed, but this is the third straight season for East versus West.
I think they've found the format that they really like now. All we see is experiment with the All-Star Games, it seemed like early in the NLL history, but I think they like this format. We'll be going with it every year. And, the players have really taken it seriously in the last few years, and I think that trend's going to continue.
1915, as you saw 2 years ago, this game looks like it's maybe headed in that kind of a scoring direction as both teams decide on how they will deal with this last possession of the first half. In a 7-7 tie, the Western Conference trying to win the game for the first time. They've lost the last 2 years, including a very bitter pill to swallow on John Tavares' overtime winner at 1:45 of the extra period last year in Calgary.
Coach Eddie Como is one of the best technicians in this game, or tactician, sorry. And he loves drawing up plays for 6-on-5 power plays. We'll see what he has up his sleeve here.
Well, the net is empty. Trying to take advantage of this last possession to its fullest. Josh Sanderson, Cosmo the save, and the net is empty.
Oh, and Cosmo's a little upset. His team just called a timeout. I think he wanted his chance to shoot for the empty net. But they probably have a better chance with 7 seconds left to pull him and work the offense for one last quick shot.
Well, they're tired of being shot at all the time. They'd like a little glory themselves. As Anthony Cosmo has really shut the door here the last few minutes for the Western Conference. Jim Veltman, he truly has been one of the legends of this game. 5 championships with the Toronto Rock, the all-time king in loose balls, and is leading in that category again this year. We'll also focus on the new Chicago franchise. It doesn't have a name yet. They're deciding on that, and we'll recap last night's Super Skills competition, all part of a Hall of Fame weekend, this All-Star contest. The head coach of the Arizona Sting. Coach of this Western Conference team, Bob Hamley.
And we joke about goaltenders trying to score a goal. Anthony Cosmo's never had one in his career, but Pat O'Toole scored 3 goals in his NLL career.
They threw it up nicely for Jonas Dierks, but Pat O'Toole with another save.
7-7, that's the way you like it heading into the second half, and I guarantee you it's going to get nastier and nastier as the game goes on, because they're having a little fun out here right now, but both teams want to win this, and it'll get more and more serious.
So we turn it down to Sam Cosentino.
Thanks, Peter, with Bob Hamley, the head coach of the Arizona Sting, and I've seen you in games past, not quite the intensity that I'm used to seeing out of you.
No, it's a fun night for everybody, including the coaches, a little more relaxed than normal.
But still doing a little bit of coaching, calling that timeout with 7.2 seconds left to drop a play. I guess you can't leave everything aside.
Well, we still want to win the game, so we're trying our best to do that.
Thanks so much.
Thanks, Sam.
That's Bob Hamley, the head coach of the Arizona Sting.
Sounds like he's still coaching over there too. An entertaining first half, including that baby from Tracy Koleski.
Allstate Insurance Company.
Hello, I'd like a car insurance quote, please.
Yeah, hi.
Hello.
Yeah, I'd like a
quote, please.
Can I have a car insurance quote?
Need a quote. Yeah, I'm looking for a car insurance quote, please.
Quote, please.
Just need a quote.
Hey, think easier. Think Progressive. We give you our direct rate for car insurance plus the rates of other top companies instantly. Go to progressive.com.
With Vonage, I talk as much as I want, pay a lot less. It's just $24.99 a month, and that includes voicemail, caller ID, three-way calling, and a lot more. The voice quality's great, and I even get to keep my same phone and phone number. I've had Vonage for 4 months. Should have gotten it a long time ago.
We're not out to change the world, just the way you talk to it. Sign up now and get your first month free. Call 1-800-939-4VON. High-speed internet connection required.
I'm here today to ask you to support the home team, Blackjack Pizza. It's the great-tasting pizza that started right here in Colorado. It's good. Better get you some of this dummy. He's just playing, right?
Better get some of this great offer. Buy a medium pizza with unlimited toppings for only $7.99 and get additional unlimited medium pizzas for only $5 each.
Oh, yeah, and while you're at it, support our other hometown teams, too. Blackjack Pizza. Stick with the home team. This is good.
Want to know what the other guy's holding? Take some tips from the legends with Inside Poker. You'll get news, interviews, and updates from all around the world of poker. Inside Poker, Sundays at 6 on Altitude.
Fires a three. Oh! Cross slice, a long shot. Score!
This is Altitude Sports and Entertainment.
Welcome back to the halftime of the sixth National Lacrosse League All-Star Game. We're knotted at seven between the East and the West. I'm joined now by Jim Beltman, the captain of the Toronto Rock, 15-year veteran of the National Lacrosse League. You have really seen this league grow by leaps and bounds.
Yeah, it's been amazing. You know, from making $125 U.S. a game in Buffalo in 92 to this, you know, and these kind of spectacles. This week's been a really special week with the Hall of Fame dinner on Thursday night, and last night's game was a really close one here in Toronto, and now the All-Star game. I mean, couldn't ask for a perfect weekend.
This is your fifth All-Star game. I guess this sort of thing never gets old.
No, it's really fun to watch what these guys can do out here, the talent and just the moves that they do. You know, they show us some practice and we kind of laugh about it, and then also Star game, they try it, so it's kind of fun to watch.
Thanks, Jimmy. Continued success.
All right, Sam. Yeah, thanks.
That's Jim Veltman from the National Lacrosse League Eastern Division All-Stars. We're knotted at seven, back with the rest of the halftime after this short break.
Do you love spending hours working out at the gym? If you do, the Total Gym is not for you.
But if you want one of the fastest, most effective workouts ever, then the Total Gym is for you.
For our 10th anniversary, we have an incredible deal.
You can try the Total Gym in your home for an entire month, risk-free.
We'll ship you a Total Gym at our expense. If you don't see a remarkable change, just send it back, and we'll return every penny you were charged. But if you're like most of us, once you try it, you'll never want to be without it again.
Just 1 year on the Total Gym, and I've lost 45 pounds.
So take our risk-free challenge and get the body you've always wanted. Why go to the gym when you can own one?
Call the number on your screen for our anniversary special. Try the Total Gym in your home risk-free for 60 days. We'll pay shipping and handling. Call now.
Beer starts out this cold, it ends up this refreshing. Coors Light.
The 2005 President's Cup champions are back. Reigning MVP Greg Pankowitz leads the first place Colorado Eagles on a quest for their second consecutive title. Watch your Colorado Eagles make history this year, only on Altitude Sports and Entertainment. Ryan Tobler and your Colorado Eagles fight for more breathing room in the Northwest, facing off against the second-place Oklahoma City Blazers. That's Blazers-Eagles, tonight at 7, only on Altitude.
The Denver Nuggets are on Altitude Sports and Entertainment.
Boykins, Miller, and your Denver Nuggets head home to Pepsi Center, where they push for a season sweep against Michael Redd and the Bucks. Bucks Nuggets. The coverage begins Monday at 6:30, only on Altitude.
Every week, Altitude hits the streets of Denver seeking out the local hotspots you want to know about. Join Kyle Keefe around the town as he checks out Denver's favorite festivals, theaters, sporting events, restaurants, shops, and more. Plus, we sit down with Hollywood's hottest stars and go behind the scenes of their latest movies. There's never a dull moment around the town. Wednesday at 5 on Altitude.
Fires a three. Oh!
watching Altitude Sports and Entertainment.
The Halftime, brought to you by Future Shop and Toshiba, proud sponsors of the 2006 National Lacrosse League.
The National Lacrosse League, on behalf of the Board of Governors, the owners of the National Lacrosse League, are pleased to announce the awarding of our 12th expansion franchise to play in the 07 season, to play here at the Sears Center here in Chicago.
And with that announcement, the National Lacrosse League has now grown to 12 teams. I'm joined now by the majority owner of the Chicago franchise, Kevin Lockery Jr. Congratulations, first off, on the franchise. But how did this thing all come together, and how long did it take?
Well, I came last year to the All-Star Game, and I had it was my first time seeing box lacrosse and indoor lacrosse, and I was just completely blown away with the excitement of the game. And we started looking at that time right away. And so that's how it came about.
When your season starts next January, there will be no less than five teams in the marketplace competing at the same time. How is your group going to be able to overcome that?
Well, we hope, you know, this league is the established lacrosse league that's out there. The league's averaging 11,000 fans a game. And we feel that in the Chicago market, we're in a brand new arena called the Sears Center. And we're real excited about being there. And we feel that our new arena, the team, and the league is going to help us bring in people.
Talk a little bit about the Sears Center, the new arena, where it is exactly and how many people it seats and so on.
It's a brand new arena. It seats 10,000 people. It is 30 minutes outside of Chicago, west of Chicago, in a really fantastically growing area, and we're excited about it. The arena will be finished in October, so we'll be the prime client in the arena, so we can't wait.
Well, thanks so much for your time, and congratulations on the 12th franchise in the National Lacrosse League. Kevin Lockery Jr., the majority owner of the Chicago NLL franchise. Check out the website at chicagonll.com. Maybe your name will be selected as the nickname of the new Chicago franchise.
Jonas Dirks really enjoyed himself yesterday during the skills competition. We will recap that when we come back. You're watching the National Lacrosse League All-Star Game live from Toronto.
Have you ever had a diet fail because you were hungry all the time? If you have, don't worry. It's not your fault. It's almost impossible to lose weight if you're always hungry. Hi, we're the creators of Right Size Smoothie. The secret is a cutting-edge appetite manager called Appamine. It's in the smoothie. You drink the smoothie, it knocks out your appetite and helps you burn more calories than you take in safely and without being hungry. And that's what leads to weight loss. Because it's such a great product, we're going to do something crazy here. Call within the next 15 minutes and we'll let you try Right Size before you buy it. Here's how it works. Just pick up the shipping and handling fee. Try the smoothies for 2 weeks, and either you lose the weight or you'll never pay for them. Operators are standing by for the next 15 minutes, so call now.
Call 1-800-318-9085. Call now to try Right Size before you buy it. Just pay shipping and handling. Call 1-800-318-9085.
Tell me to take risks. Tell me it's okay to fail if I get back up and try again. Tell me to walk up to fear and show who's stronger. Tell me to throw every inch of myself into everything I do.
One night ago, the stars of the National Lacrosse League put on a skills display, a competition. Best shooter, Gavin Proud of the Colorado Mammoth. Look out for this. Ooh, John Grant scares me every time. The Rock. Rochester Nighthawks, and then in the breakaway creativity, or shootout creativity. Yes, he received 58 points, did Jonas Dirks of the Arizona State. He's got a lot of flash in that. There's the Gate brothers, who are part of the judging crew, two of the best players to ever perform in the game of lacrosse, and it's been a pretty entertaining all-star affair as well, with a 7-7 tie after the first 30 minutes of action.
Well, when you look at the stats, there's no surprise that the score is tied. Shots on goal pretty even. Loose balls pretty even. The face-offs in favor of the West. And just one power play. You're not going to expect to see a lot of power plays in an all-star game.
And we will change goaltenders for half number two, which means for the Eastern Conference, we will see Steve Dietrich, who's having a wonderful year with the Buffalo Bandits in his second all-star appearance. The product of Kitchener, Ontario. Leads the league in goals against at 9.25 a game. And at the other end for the Western Conference, well, this guy is a legend.
41
years
old.
There's been six All-Star games. He's played in all of them.
He played with the Philadelphia Wings for 15 years before he got traded to Portland this year. And what a homecoming he had. Portland played in Philadelphia for the first time last week. Portland won that game behind Dallas Elliott. I'm sure a lot of the Philly fans had mixed feelings about that one, but he's been a two-time All-Star in the championship game. He's won four championships for the Philadelphia Wings.
A 41-year-old from Vancouver, British Columbia, Dallas Elliott. Second half of this 2006 National Lacrosse League All-Star Game is underway. Does anybody want to collect this loose ball? Will anybody collect it? I repeat, will anyone collect this loose ball?
Well, nobody's quitting on it, I'll tell you that.
Dan Carey did. He scored two goals in the first half and nearly had a third had it not been for a great save from Pat O'Toole. Caleb Tope, his pass scooped up by John Tavares. The 37-year-old one-hands it. Doyle, Clark, his second of the day in the Eastern Conference. Back and forth.
Well, that goal started with John Tavares' pass. John Tavares was playing defense on that shift. And scooped the ball up the floor and a nice backhand pass. Old teammates. Paul Doyle to Glenn Clark. Glenn Clark has played defense his career in the NLL, but he's always been a pretty decent transition player. Can put the ball in the net with a little bit of regularity.
John Tavares with his 19th, so make that 18th All-Star point, so he's tied for top spot in that category all time in his fifth All-Star affair. With Paul Cantabine, both with 18 points in All-Star affairs. Bergey, nice pass, Manning in front. But the offering goes astray, and it's Taylor Ray. Ray with a goal in the opening half, a member of the Calgary Roughnecks. Derek Mulaski, the San Jose still a drive. Good save by Steve Dietrich of the Buffalo Bandits. Dietrich just fits in that net. Like the size of the net was made for him. He's an excellent goaltender. He's been around for quite some time. He's right up there in terms of all-time leaders and saves.
He's also been an MVP in a championship game. Three of the goaltenders in this game. Dietrich, Pat O'Toole, and Dallas Elliott have all been MVPs in championship games. Look at the points. In All-Star games, Tavares now tied for the lead with Canavine on third. Tavares will move ahead before the night's over.
Danny Merrill of Philadelphia Wings. Right back, Lane Manning, bumped in the corner by Jage Albert, the Colorado Mammoth. Nice work from Ryan Sharp. Great lead pass for Bruce Codd of the Arizona Sting by himself. Another excellent save by Dietrich, showing you why he has the league's best goals against average. And a 4-2 record for Buffalo in their first six games. Radcliffe, oh, he stepped in. It was a nice try by Lewis nonetheless. Long lead pass. Oh, my goodness.
I thought that one was coming.
So did I, and I thought it might go in, too, between the legs from Toronto Rocks. Colin Doyle, did you see that?
A little splash.
Oh, and how does that feel across that bare leg? Boy, Mr. Dietrich has answered the bell early on in the Eastern Conference goal.
Before playing for Buffalo, Dietrich played many years for Rochester. 1997, they won the championship. He was the MVP. As I said, three of the goalies playing out here have been the MVP in the championship game. Oh, my.
Mark Steenhuis, no stranger to scoring in All-Star games. And he has added to the Eastern Conference lead.
Watch him take advantage of this pick by Big Jake Bergey. Nice pick, and he just cuts inside. I don't think the pick made the difference so much as his good footwork getting through.
First of the day, he now has 3 points in the contest. 2 assists early on in the contest for the Eastern Conference. A member of the Buffalo Bandits, Derek Miloski. Collects it. Miloski wants to shoot it. Nope. Decides to pass. Broken up that time by Glenn Clark, who has a pair of goals for the Eastern Conference in the end. Craig Kahn. The Arizona Sting. He can score. 22 during the season. Right up there, along with John Grant Jr., who has 32, and Aaron Wilson of the Toronto Rock, not playing today. But he'll be in an All-Star game pretty soon. Scored 5 last night for Toronto and has 27 on the year.
Oh, absolutely. And, you know, every year there's a few great players who somehow don't get in the All-Star game. Josh Sanderson last year wasn't in the All-Star game. So there's great company who don't make it to this game.
Wonderful passing. And you probably heard the doink off the iron. They keep it up. Danny Merrill into the corner. Here in Philadelphia for the Wings, Sean Williams has connected for his first ever All-Star goal.
Tavares just kept that going out of the line.
I can't wait to see that again. Just to even catch that pass, let alone spin and let a rocket go behind your back. You know, he deserved a goal there.
You know what? Let me see the replay. I think that one was going for the top corner. Made a great save on that one.
That left me speechless, and as most people know, that's not easy to do.
I don't think that's possible.
As the truck goes wild after that cover. Caleb Tope for Brody Merrill. And the 30-second time clock expires. Colin Doyle, the second leading scorer in the league, shows you why.
Nice pass by Tavares. Oh, yeah. That had the top corner peg.
What a catch, first of all. Bergman of the Edmonton Rush, and Dietrich has just been spectacular early in the second half. Steenhuis, who just made it 9-7 with his first of the day. Loading it up with John Grant. Block. Ryan Sharp. Self. A strip. Is that going to be a penalty?
I don't think so.
No.
It was a nice stick check.
Oh, I thought I saw a little holding call.
Yes, it was a penalty.
I did. We'll straighten it out when we return.
States Army Reserve. We are regular people who share our time serving our country and our communities. Our training makes us stronger as soldiers and as citizens who stand ready.
To find out how you can serve your country in the Army Reserve, call 1-888-624-ARMY for this free DVD and get a free sports watch. Stand ready in the Army Reserve.
Hoops fans, want to get away? Well, here's your chance to hit the links and catch a little round ball action. Southwest Airlines and Altitude are teaming up to treat you like a pro. Log on to Altitude.tv for your chance to see Denver when they travel to Phoenix on Saturday, March 25th. Winners will receive airfare, hotel, game tickets, and a round of golf, courtesy of Southwest Airlines and Altitude Sports and Entertainment. Southwest Airlines, a symbol of freedom.
The 2005 President's Cup champions are back. Reigning MVP Greg Pankowitz leads the first-place Colorado Eagles on a quest for their second consecutive title. Watch your Colorado Eagles make history this year, only on Altitude Sports and Entertainment. Ryan Tobler and your Colorado Eagles fight for more breathing room in the Northwest, facing off against the second-place Oklahoma City Blazers. That's Blazers-Eagles, next, only on Altitude.
This quarter, brought to you by RBK, proud to be the exclusive supplier of equipment, uniforms, footwear, and apparel for the NLL. And by Molson Canadian. For true Canadian taste from Canada's oldest brewery, it starts here.
The Olympic break is just about over, which means the National Hockey League, Molson Canadian Hockey on Rogers Sportsnet returns. We've got the next one for the Leafs on Tuesday, taking on Washington. Coverage begins with Sportsnet News, and then on Thursday on Sportsnet East, it's the Ottawa Senators against Alexander Ovechkin again on the network, and the rest of the Washington Capitals. Here's Sam Cosentino.
Thanks, Peter, with Steve Stoll. Steve Toll representing the Eastern Division All-Stars, the Rochester Nighthawks. How important is it for you guys to win this game for bragging rights over the West?
I think it is a lot of bragging rights. I mean, game doesn't really mean that much right here, right now, but down the road, definitely, we see all these boys in the summertime and the wintertime, and it means a lot to us.
Nicknamed Speed and Stevie Toll, our analyst Brian Shanahan says there may be a new title holder for that in Cam Bergman.
Yeah, he's pretty fast. I still score more goals, but he's faster.
Thanks, Stevie.
You're welcome.
Back upstairs, guys.
Here's our second penalty of this All-Star contest.
Yes, on second look. The first one was a hold. The second one was a good stick check. That's what I thought they called him on originally.
John Grant in the penalty box. He's usually scoring power play goals. But sits down. A chance for the West is the Eastern Conference in front by a pair. The West yet to score in this second half. Craig Kahn is capable but can't control it. And now Glenn Clark shorthanded looking for his third of the game. The pipe, and then it nearly caromed off the veteran Dallas Elliott in the goal. Tavares had a chance. The net had come loose, and it didn't matter because the 41-year-old stopped it anyway.
Glenn Clark, two goals going for the hat trick. Beat at Dallas Elliott, but he didn't beat the post. What a homecoming. I know yesterday was his homecoming, but in his second visit back to the ACC, not as a home player, I'm sure he would have loved that.
Too many men on the floor is the call against the Stars of the Eastern Conference. And look at Glenn Clark. He so wanted to score a third goal. So this is difficult. 5-on-3. The Western Conference working with a man up. Molaski. Good save again. Dietrich, who's been perfect so far in goal. Toll. And Mark Steenhuis, who has a second-half goal here in the third quarter.
Steenhuis has two shorthanded goals this year. He always wants to go to the net.
Craig Kahn, Arizona's the leader in that category with three.
Oh.
There was Tavares coming off the boards. Looking for the pass. That was just over top of his stick. 33 seconds left in the two-man advantage for the Western Conference, and that's what they trail by. Caleb Toth. Carey works it. Radcliffe, is it number two of the day? Yes, it is.
Not your typical goal on a 4-on-3. This one's just an outside shot. Usually it's a bang, bing, bang, boom, and an empty net. This one is just an outside shot. They give him a bit too much room, not enough respect. So Radcliffe says, I'm going to shoot this one myself.
Second of the day for the member of the Calgary Roughnecks. The 24-year-old from Victoria, British Columbia, is Lewis Radcliffe. Brody Merrill. Seconds left and a power play. terrific feed. Toth to Molaski. Beat Dietrich, but couldn't beat the Irish. And that'll about do it for the West power play. They did connect one time on the goal by Ratcliffe. Danny Merrill. Watched closely by Bergman as Colin Doyle's penalty. He served the too many men on the floor. Comes to a conclusion. Doyle scored five goals in the 2004 game. Perry has two today. Craig Kahn looking for his first, stopped by Dietrich. Ratcliffe racing in. Takes a bump from Ryan Cousins of Minnesota. And it's intercepted by Steve Toll, who says...
He's going to show us.
Yes, he is going to show us right here. Steenhuis with Hayek. Waiting. And as the dearly departed bless his soul, Ed Whalen used to say, that was a malfunction at the junction. Koleski is stopped. So is Molaski. Four great goaltending from the Buffalo Bandit. Steven Dietrich.
Molaski's been snake bitten. He's had some great scoring chances. That's a guy who can put the ball in the net. He holds a record for most points in a game at 14, tied with a few others, Derek Keenan and Gary Gate. Just 1 point so far today.
14 points in one game. My goodness. That's a pile for the member now of the San Jose Stealth, number 18 for the Western Conference, Derek Molaski. This is Sean Williams. Grant played for Bergey, who has 3 points in the game, a goal and two assists of the Philadelphia Wings. John Tavares, look out! Oh, he knew it was coming when he loaded it up, but Dallas Elliott, who's probably seen more of John Tavares than anyone would like to or want to.
That's a better save than it looked like. Not only did he make a save, it's very difficult to control the rebound on a John Tavares shot from out there.
Tavares can work you over at the other end, too. Steenhuis rocked it for Cousins. Couldn't accept the pass. Talked about the game getting rougher and tougher as it goes along. We're starting to see a little of that the last couple of moments in this third quarter.
Tavares is playing defense again. I'll tell you a little story about that when we get a chance.
Terry for his third of the day. Dietrich blows the shin guards in a hurry. Molaski, look at him go upstairs in search of a loose ball. Lewis Ratcliffe has two goals in this game. He's a member of the Calgary Roughnecks. He's brought the West to within one.
You know, there's a name for people like you.
Artiste.
Yeah, and why not tell the entire world? Just go to GoDaddy.com and get your .com name for only $8.95 a year. Register your .com name, and everyone will see you for the Picasso of the pipes that you are. Who knows how much money you'll make?
Thanks, sweetie. You're an angel.
Actually, I ride with GoDaddy.com. Now you can get a new .com name for only $3.99 when you purchase any other GoDaddy product.
Why buy a flatbed when now you can enjoy any size Craftmatic 3 adjustable bed free? If you ever had a bad night's sleep or felt sore or stiff, back, neck, or shoulder pain, Craftmatic would love to give you an adjustable bed free. Call for this free color catalog and enter our adjustable bed sweepstakes. That's all it takes. So please call to learn how this fabulous free bed may provide temporary relief from nighttime heartburn, gastric reflux, or just poor sleep. So if you've always wanted an adjustable bed, now here's your opportunity to get yours free. Before you buy any bed, even on sale at 50% off, call for your free color catalog featuring the surprisingly affordable Craftmatic 2, your adjustable bed at quality flatbed prices. This fabulous free bed could be yours, but you must make that free call now.
This bed is fantastic.
To get everything free, call now.
To enter to win yours free, call 1-800-981-2772. That's 1-800-981-2772. Call now.
Today's fan question of the game is brought to you by RBK, proud to be the exclusive supplier of equipment, uniforms, footwear, and apparel for the NLL. Tonight's question, or at least today's, is from Ron Hines of Scarborough, Ontario. And he asks, is Josh Sanderson the best setup man ever to play in the league? fans, please email your lacrosse question to your call at sportsnet.rogers.com, and we might answer it on our next broadcast.
That's civil answer, yes. He is the best setup man. A few years back, 2002, he set the record with the most assists, 68 assists. Last year, he broke his own record with 71. He's on pace to get 80 this year. Josh Sanderson is a great setup man, and he is the best ever.
And we're going to tee him up right now. Going in the other direction. The assist this time to Sam.
Thanks, Peter. With Josh Sanderson now, and the question was asked from one of our fans, are you the best setup man ever to play? You're not going to probably agree with that statement. That's be a little not like you, but what makes you so good in that department?
I'm playing with a lot of good guys up there. Even when I was in San Jose / Albany, you know, Aaron Wilson's, he should be in this game. He's an unbelievable goal scorer. And then you got Blaine and Colin, two of the best in the game. So, you know, you play with good guys. We got Shears, we got Chris. So, you know, good guys around you.
How important is it for you to be able to play this game in front of the home fans?
Oh, it's fun. It's, you know, playing with world-class players, so I'm just having a lot of fun with it.
And so are the guys on the bench, guys.
Yeah, it's really hard to tell. Well, come dressed for the match. Rock fans? Yeah, that's a great set of get-ups right there, enjoying this 2006 National Lacrosse League All-Star Contest, as are we. Hope you are wherever you're looking on. Ryan Sharp. Nice feed now, Bergman! Steve Toll's going, see, he can't score like I can. That's a great save again by Dietrich, who's making it, frankly, look pretty easy.
Well, I'll tell you, that was a pretty good speed by Sharp, Dalbert, and Bergman. All three of them came out of their end pretty fast. Great transition.
Fun to watch. A steal from Scott Self. Joined by Sharp. Dishes off instead. Now the pass towards Sharp. Broken up. Gavin Prout with another loose ball. The all-time all-star game leader in that category from the Colorado Mammoth. Cole battling Sharp. The edge of the crease. And this loose ball belongs to Philadelphia captain Tom Hyatt, who is a very good hockey player. He was a four-year member of the Vermont Catamounts. Manning receives a pick, lays it off. This is John Grant with Colin Doyle. They run the pick and roll. Great patience. Doyle still has it. Shot clock to two. Bergey lugout. Blaine Manning not so appreciative of that last second drive. He got hit with
it. Watch this shot by... Oh, yeah. That was Bruce Codd took that one on the shoulder from a Jake Bergey shot.
Manning was more upset than Codd, and Codd was the guy who got hit with it. Caleb Toth, you don't want him to hit you with his blast. Pass didn't work. Craig Kahn ended up with a chance. A little sloppy around the net. Tavares, his Buffalo mate, Steenhuis. Always exciting as number nine with the orange shoes. Well, there he goes again. Behind his back, look at that move.
Oh.
My goodness!
Called on the crease.
Give it to him, it's an all-star game.
I don't care, that was still pretty.
No goal. What a move. This guy could get free in a phone booth.
Yeah. Beats Dan Carey pretty good here. Little showboating. Nobody likes that.
And he did step in there, too.
Yeah, sure, Dan Carey's one of the happiest when he gets called for it. Doesn't matter whether it's an all-star game yet. The hate when somebody makes you look foolish.
And he can make you look silly. 9-8 it remains. The pace of scoring is slowed in the second half. As I see that, Glenn Clark just misses another hat trick attempt.
Glenn Clark is going for that hat trick, no doubt about it. Most games he would have passed that one off.
The Western Conference caught this time with too many players on the floor. I didn't think we'd have one power play opportunity. There's been a two-man advantage already. Bob Hamley, I think a little wry smile on his face, the head coach of the Arizona Sting. I heard him the other day talk about the fact that now that it's his full-time gig in Arizona, he says, it's even harder to deal with the losses because you got more time to think about it.
A little more pressure when it's a real job and your family's depending on it.
Not a bad place to spend a winter. Merrill plays it at the point on this power play. Sanderson, Merrill can crank it, does, but fires wide of Dallas Elliott. The interception by Dan Merrill. Minute and a half. Too many men on the floor. The result of this Eastern Conference power play attack. Look at that feed for Williamson. How about Taylor Ray closing the gap defensively? Not going to close this, but an excellent save by Dallas Elliott to keep his team within a goal. Oh, my goodness. Taylor Ray just about lost his bucket that time. Calgary Roughneck, who has a goal.
Oh, nice play.
Tommy Hayek for Jimmy Veltman of the Toronto Rock. He waits for his mates to join on board. Killing off some penalty time and now working on the power play. John Grant thought about loading up the big shot. Behind his back he goes. Grant one more time, and there it is. John Grant, 32, to lead the league on the season, and there's his second of the day.
Yesterday he had the hardest shot, 157 kilometers per hour. I think he took something off this one. It was just going about 140. But he picks the corner. Yes, and Ellick even gets a piece of this. Got a piece of it, but that shot was a little too fast.
John Grant. Quite a player. Loose ball. Ryan Cousins with Steenhuis. And they'll pull it up. Here's a shot off the bench. Williams, another try. It didn't beat the buzzer. The Eastern Conference thought it did. But the official says no. 10-8. Or at least 10-8. The Eastern Conference leads after three. Here's a piece.
Watch the buzzer. You know, this is the same referee who reffed the game Calgary and Edmonton last week when Edmonton scored the winning goal with 0.2 seconds to go. He made the right call then, and he made the right call today. I think he's feeling a little less pressure this time.
John Williams didn't like it, but it was definitely the right call. One quarter remaining.
The closer you approach to God, the simpler you will become.
This was my prom. My spring break. Road trip with friends. Summer camp. Semester abroad. Thanksgiving. What do you call a life dedicated to hockey? I'd call it time well spent.
The intensity, unyielding. The excitement, unstoppable. The action, unbelievable. B2 Networks is the only place to watch all 96 National Lacrosse League games this season. To view the 2006 season NLL games live, go to NLL.com 10 minutes prior to game. Click on the B2 icon. Cost $6 a game. B2. Continue to dream.
Today, Matthew has no rules. Just joy.
I like the snow. The snow tastes like popsicle.
He has no worries. Just wonderment. Today, my son Matthew isn't a kid who is sick. He's just a kid. With a wish to see snow. My
lucky day. Mark your calendar for Sunday, April 2nd for the annual Avs Better Halves Charity Brunch
and fashion show at the new Hyatt Regency Convention Center Hotel. This heartwarming event features Avs players, coaches, and better halves, as well as special ambassadors from the Children's Hospital in a special fashion show by Neiman Marcus. This is your opportunity to see the players in different roles, all to support Colorado Children's Charities, including the Children's Hospital. For ticket information, visit coloradoavalanche.com.
This quarter, brought to you by RBK, proud to be the exclusive supplier of equipment, uniforms, footwear, and apparel for the NLL. And by Molson Canadian. For true Canadian taste from Canada's oldest brewery, it starts here.
Through three quarters of play, it's 10-8 Eastern Division All-Stars over the West, joined now by Anthony Cosmo, who played the first half in goal and a couple of years ago, a major trade sending you to San Jose, but that's really sparked your career as you've gotten a chance to play there.
Yeah, you know, playing behind Bob Watson, you know, there's no better player to play behind, but, you know, it was good for me to get traded and get to play and start these games, you know. It's only been better for me and helping my game quite a bit.
Notice Steve Dietrich, the Eastern goalie, walked by here just moments ago, and you continue to urge him to play well, even though he's on the other team, but that goalie fraternity is pretty tight.
Oh yeah, we're all friends here. You know, these guys aren't all-stars for any reason. These guys got some good shooters on both teams, so, you know, just hang tight for Stevie, and even though I want to win, you know, we all want to have some fun here.
Thanks, Anthony.
Thanks so much. Just want to say hi to all the teachers and all the students at St. Herbert's. Thanks so much.
That's Anthony Cosmo, goaltender for the San Jose Stuff.
Nice touch from the netminder, who performed very well in his 30 minutes of work. Here we are after 45 minutes.
Pretty even game. Loose balls. The West has really taken advantage on that and on the faceoffs, but he still leads in the score.
Jalbert looking for his fifth assist to Dan Carey, his Colorado teammate who couldn't pull the trigger on his third. Here's another gentleman who might score three, and not Colin Doyle. Oh my goodness, there is a goal. And quite a goal on the pass from Glenn Clark, who did have two goals before that assist. And Colin Doyle with another beauty, and we're quite accustomed to that.
Glenn Clark has really been involved in the offense, but look at this finish. But Colin Doyle fakes it behind the back and then takes it behind the back.
Colin Doyle of the Toronto Rock, second in the league in scoring. Brian mentioned earlier, last year he led the league in scoring and was the MVP, and he was the MVP of the Champions Cup. So he did it all in another Toronto Rock title run. Koleski of the Calgary Roughnecks with a entertaining goal today already. What a feed for his teammate, Lewis Ratcliffe. And there's Ratcliffe. He has three goals today.
You know, Koleski made that pass to Ratcliffe. I don't think Ratcliffe was even expecting it, but Koleski knew he was going to get open. Watch this feed as Ratcliffe's coming behind the net. Ratcliffe's actually behind the net when he catches it. Nice pass. And he just whips it around the corner. Ratcliffe's having quite a game, too.
As the song Magic plays in the background, we've seen plenty of that. Taking it easy. He's done anything but in his work time. He's only allowed two goals in this half. For these shooters, that's quite an accomplishment. 7-7 at halftime, 11-9 in favor of the Eastern Conference. Taylor Ray, Calgary defender. Brody Merrill of the Portland Lumberjacks. For Scott Self, the drive, and Dietrich keeps it out again. Glenn Clark might start to receive a little MVP attention as this one wears down. Colin Doyle trying to follow up that brilliant goal with maybe another. Flash it wide. John Tavares, what a pass! Merrill behind his back. Talked about John Tavares, the defender, not the great offensive star.
Yes, I was actually surprised. I was talking to him a few days ago, and he said there'll come a time in this league where he wants to play defense. He wants to play the back door. He thinks it'll extend his career. Often superstars want to end as the big scorers like this guy here, and it's actually the guy, Mark Steenhuis, who John Tavares told me will be the guy taking over for him in Buffalo as the top scorer. And he says he'd be quite happy to go to the back door, play some defense while Steenhuis carries the offense. As you can see the speed of Steenhuis. Might be switching positions because Steenhuis plays a lot of D and he scores this goal off D on the transition. And I think even if John Tavares ever goes back on D, he'll be scoring a lot of points from back there as well.
Second goal in the D for Steenhuis and his fourth point. He was the MVP of this game 2 years ago in Colorado when he scored an all-star record 6 goals. He's got 4 points, and there's another Eastern Conference goal, courtesy of Minnesota's Daryl Gibson. They call him the Doctor of Defense, but he's got a little O2, apparently.
Absolutely. Daryl Gibson, who once played for the Toronto Rock, he actually scored 2 goals in the championship victory over Albany. And got traded around a little bit, has made his way to Minnesota. He was a replacement, as you mentioned, to Marshall Abrams.
Oh, things starting to go awry for the Western Conference. That's an excellent save by Elliott. Gibson does not have a goal this year in Minnesota. 4 assists on the year, but has an all-star goal. To be dazzling on the floor for Bergey. They just fail to make the connection. Gavin Prout leads the game in loose balls, and he's the all-time all-star leader in that category. Can't believe that Jim Feltman actually isn't the leader in that category because he is everywhere else. Greg Kahn, bothered by Gibson, who has just scored behind his back. He didn't miss by much. The biggest lead of the day for the Eastern Conference. What a seesaw affair until the last few minutes.
Oh, still a long way from over, as we've seen many times.
Yeah, like 24 hours
ago. Yes.
Less than 24 hours ago. Williams for Blaine Manning. Sharp giving him a headache. Time clock runs out, and here's a break. Bergman trying to feed it through for Jalbert, who has it now. B. Jalbert. Plays it. Goes to the side of the net, tries to play it in the short side, but Dietrich took it away. Here's Molaski, intercepted by Steenie Toll, and yes, he can run from Rochester. Leaves it. Phil Sanderson of the Rock.
He was with Toll step for step.
Toll again. Great pass, but in the crease area was Tommy Hyatt. Brody Merrill up the floor for the Western Conference. They have some work to do with just under 10 minutes to go in regulation. Trailing by 4, the Eastern Conference trying to make it 3 straight wins over the West. Koleski in a battle with Tavares, who is back on defense. And leads the transition. Glenn Clark got tripped up by the white line. But the only mistake he's made in this game. He has a couple of goals. The Philadelphia wing defender. For Colin Doyle of the Rock. Well, he dropped his stick off the ball, and Grant got upended. Caleb Toth in the Western Conference trailing the Eastern Conference Stars by 4.
What are you setting your sights on? And when you see it, will you be ready? Just pick up the phone, dial 1-800-645-ARMY, and you'll get this free DVD. You'll learn about the hundreds of opportunities the Army can offer you. Skills, education, healthcare. Call 1-800-645-ARMY, and you'll also get this free boonie hat. Whatever you're looking for, the Army can help you find it.
The world of sports is filled with incredible triumphs, unforgettable comebacks, and legendary moments that transcend the game. And Altitude goes one-on-one with the legends who make these moments happen.
I enjoy going to the rink every day, and it puts a smile on my face.
Everybody has been doing a great job. Everybody's been contributing.
Are you surfing now, Rob?
More than ever.
Mike Haynes sits down with Steve Govett, the general manager of the Colorado Mammoth. Sunday at 7:30, only on Altitude.
The Denver Nuggets are on Altitude Sports and Entertainment.
Boykins, Miller, and your Denver Nuggets head home to Pepsi Center, where they push for a season sweep against Michael Redd and the Bucks. Bucks Nuggets. The coverage begins Monday at 6:30, only on Altitude.
Every week, Altitude hits the streets of Denver seeking out the local hotspots you want to know about. Join Kyle Keefe around the town as he checks out Denver's favorite festivals, theaters, sporting events, restaurants, shops, and more. Plus, we sit down with Hollywood's hottest stars and go behind the scenes of their latest movies. There's never a dull moment around the town. Wednesday at 5 on Altitude.
You're watching Altitude Sports and Entertainment.
This quarter brought to you by Molson Canadian. For true Canadian taste from Canada's oldest brewery, it starts here.
This copyright telecast of the National Lacrosse League Incorporated may not be retransmitted, reproduced, or rebroadcast without the expressed written consent of the National Lacrosse League. Joining us, Mr. Cosentino. Sam?
Thanks, Peter. I'm with Colin Doyle now, and just before the break, you saw him lose his stick, but I understand that play was by design.
We were trying to do some trickery, myself and Junior there. You don't get a chance to play with these guys every day, so I thought I'd make the best of it, but it didn't work out. Maybe we'll have something else in store.
Is that something you worked on in the shoot-around?
We just thought about what we talked about and said, if we get up four, we'll try it. And we got up four, and we went right to it. It took about six tries to get to it, though.
And we can expect it maybe to happen once more?
I would think so.
All right, thanks for your time.
Right on.
That's Colin Doyle of the Toronto Rock, second leading scorer in the National Lacrosse League.
One of the all-time best.
I'm glad they waited till they're up by four before they tried that move. They don't want to be saving that one for overtime.
Colin Doyle is fifth all-time in terms of career points. John Grant leads the league in goals with 32, has two in this game for the leaders, the Eastern Conference All-Stars. Gavin Rugg trying to bring his team back. Caleb Toth. Steve Deep. No wonder he's the league's top goalie this year. Bounce pass. A nifty one. Phil Sanderson. He has three assists.
And a really nifty play. He bounced a pass to his teammate off the backboards there. Great little play.
Steenhuis, possibly a second MVP in an All-Star game. The way he's performed, but Williams, excellent reaction that time in goal from Dallas Elliott. Oh. Peter Locke to Carey. He was looking for number three of the day, but not so.
Great effort.
What an effort by Bruce Codd of the Arizona Sting. Selling out. Here's a chance. Hayek. Eastern Conference stars just fail to make the connection.
Todd Peters back. Oh my gosh. He made sure he got that loose ball, but took some pain for it. He was second in the NLL on loose balls to Jim Velpin a few years back. Nobody's ever beaten Velpin, but it's always a big deal if he can be second.
John Tavares with a little room to operate. This could be a show. Tavares, no siree. Elliott with a great save. One great veteran against the other. And the netminder won that battle. Tavares with another chance. For the Buffalo Bandits. To another Bandit. Steenhuis, 4 points already on the day. 2-2. so quick. Steenhuis trying to get free of Craig Kahn. Let's it go, and Elliott with another save. The difference remains four. Here's a chance for the West. Behind his back is Ratcliffe. He has three already in the game. He leads all players in the goal category. Lewis Ratcliffe finds Caleb Toth, his teammate in Calgary. Look out, the big blast! He missed. Tavares running after the loose ball. And now, 37-year-old goes to the bench in his fifth All-Star appearance. He just loved it. Good friend Mr. Cosentino always says he loves it. And John Tavares has been so great because he loves it. He was on the floor before this game, I swear, for almost 2 hours before it started. Boy, there's something to love. J.J. Bear, the Colorado Mammoth, his first goal to go along with four assists. It's the second time in an All-Star game he's had 5 points.
He's a two-time All-American from Virginia, one of the field lacrosse players who converted to box lacrosse, and he's really excelled and learned this game, which was new to him after graduating from college. He's a big player, plays defense on Colorado, but he scores a lot of goals as well.
From Huntington, New York is J.J. Albert, and the difference is three with an eternity of time in this sport. 6:18. See if they can convert this into another goal. Taylor Ray. Cross floor. Pulaski to the front of the net. Craig Kahn, stopped by Dietrich, kicked into the corner. Who will win this battle? Derek Pulaski of the San Jose Stealth will. In front, Pulaski! Oh, some kind of stop by Dietrich. Fabulous save by the Buffalo Bandit. Kahn. His pass off his stick, and here's Steenhuis. By himself. Steenhuis looking for his hat trick goal. And Elliott with a fine effort.
Steenhuis is all over the floor playing defense, getting the scoring chances, picking up a lot of loose balls. It's definitely a player you notice. It's not just because of the shoes.
No. Caleb Toth. Forget that goal he scored in the 1999 championship game as a member of the Rock with 1 second left at Maple Leaf Gardens. And there's a little Caleb Toth behind his back. Another fine stop by Steve Dietrich. Brian, that shot in 1999 personally turned me on to this game. That game was just fabulous.
And I think you were one of many Canadians. I can still say that maybe the turning point for lacrosse in this country. A lot of people saw that goal. That was the last professional game played at Maple Leaf Gardens. And it was won in dramatic fashion.
Thoroughly enjoyed that contest. And there is a goal courtesy of Derek Pulaski, who was sent in by himself. And Pulaski, playing in his fourth All-Star game, is on the board. And now the difference is just two.
Well, Derek Pulaski has had many scoring chances this game. He just, when he beat the goaltender, he was hitting the post. And this time he puts it in for his second point. First goal of the game.
The 32-year-old from Coquitlam, British Columbia, has drawn the Western Conference to within a pair. Phil Sanderson just missed. Feltman is Rock teammate. Phil Sanderson in front. Goes great ball movement. Steenhuis. Elliott's really bearing down when his team needs him the most. The 41-year-old veteran in his sixth consecutive game as an All-Star. Loose ball on the floor for Craig Kahn. Long pass. Dietrich out of the net. a two-goal difference. Jalbert hits they score. Koleski and the Calgary Roughnecks. And we're in for another good finish. Koleski's second of the day, and it's 13-12.
Koleski was just hiding in the weeds, and when Jalbert came up the floor, Koleski snuck out into the crease area. And that's a nice no-look pass by J.J. Albert. Koleski finishes it off. But last night, you and I did the game between Philadelphia and Toronto. Bob Watson made some saves when it looked like Philadelphia was going to run away with the game. Dallas Elliott has done the same thing to the West in the last few minutes.
Here's Prout for the equalizer. Dietrich comes up huge. Jalbert with the assist on the goal by Koleski. Jalbert now has 6 points in the game. To lead everyone, John Grant. Elliott just got a piece. Jake Bergey out of the corner versus Ryan Sharp. Here's a blast from Danny Merrill.
Oh, look at this.
Long lead feed. The speedy Bergman. He scores. Cam Bergman of the Edmonton Rush has tied the game as the West come all the way back from a 13-9 deficit to draw even.
And it's the save by Elliott, but a nice pass. And these goalies, they know how to throw it ahead of the speedsters, knowing that Bergman's going to run into it. What a week he's had. Cam Bergman playing in his first All-Star game, scores his first All-Star goal a week after he scored the winning goal for Edmonton in their first franchise victory against the Alberta Rivals Calgary.
Dallas Elliott keeping his team in and then setting up the tying goal. Bergman. Here's the West again for the lead. Malosky diving in front, knocked down. Good defensive play by Hyatt. Jelp there for Radcliffe. Stopped by Dietrich. Off the boards it goes in a 13-13 tie. Might we be headed for extra time for a second consecutive All-Star contest? Maybe. And why not? Steenhuis. Tried a trick and it backfired. Jody Merrill. He stopped Brody Merrill. Stopped by Dietrich. On a breakaway. Brody Merrill robbed by that man, Stevie Dietrich. Cam Bergman has tied it. We'll be back with the remaining 139 next.
Join us and Joe Bradley's after the game.
We are the men and women of the United States Army Reserve. We are regular people who share our time serving our country and our communities. Our training makes us stronger as soldiers and as citizens who stand ready.
To find out how you can serve your country in the Army Reserve, call 1-888-624-ARMY for this free DVD and get a free sports watch. Stand ready in the Army Reserve.
Hi, I'm Meredith Baxter, and I'd like to talk to you about families for a minute. Mine and yours. The love we have for our families is too strong to die, even if we do. That's why there's life insurance. And because everyone should be able to afford to protect their loved ones, there's Garden State Life, where you can easily get up to $50,000 of quality life insurance to help your family if something happens to you. There's no medical exam. It's affordable. There's no waiting periods. You get 100% starting the very first day, and your benefits will never go down. There's no high-pressure sales visits. You can do it all by phone or mail. Families need all the protection they can get. So you can even add life insurance for all of your children under the age of 21 to your policy. Garden State Life is protecting my family. And what about yours?
Call 1-800-470-3838 now. Garden State Life, the company you can count on for life. That's 1-800-470-3838.
This quarter, brought to you by Molson Canadian. For true Canadian taste from Canada's oldest brewery, it starts here.
The next edition of Sportsnet News coming your way with Jim Van Horn. Another dynamite day for Canada at the Winter Olympic Games in Torino. World Golf Championship match play and the Raptors in action against one of the league's best teams. We'll have that for you coming your way following this broadcast. 13-13 in the All-Star Game. 1:39 to go. Last year, the contest in Calgary required overtime, and 1:45 in, one of the superstars of this game, John Tavares, with the goal, beating Gene Nash.
And that was Jim Moss, the 2004 Defensive Player of the Year. Sorry, the 2003 Defensive Player of the Year that John Tavares beat there. So that was no slouch. And that was a great way to finish. And it looks like there's a chance, but there's still a minute and a half. Chance we might be going overtime again.
The net is empty here. Now, it's Dietrich on his way back. John Flynn switched hands and hit the post. He switched hands that time. Taylor Ray in front of the net for Brody Merrill. A couple of great scoring defenders, especially in the case of Merrill, who, along with Steve Toll, lead the league in that department with 17 points. As Merrill's had two wonderful chances to give the West the lead here. Tavares. Oh. What a save by Dallas Elliott. He robbed his man from close range. What a save by Elliott, who shut the door since his team trailed 13-9 into the last minute of this All-Star contest. Ratcliffe stopped. Dirk's diving in, and Dietrich would have none of it. Tavares. Oh, he's interested in offense now. Tavares for John Grant. Two of the best ever. His shot misses from close range. And a timeout with 24.4 to go, called by Bob Hamley, the head coach of the Western Conference All-Stars. Once again, here's Sam Cosentino.
Thanks, Peter. Just on the bench here by the Western side, and Bob Hamley was so calm, cool, and collected when we talked to him at the end of the first half. Has been on the bench and screaming like it's the regular season. In fact, as time was winding down there at the 25-second mark, he got up to the top of the bench screaming at the top of his lungs to get a timeout. He's currently drawing up a play for the West, who will have possession.
You can never hold it against a man to be passionate.
Well, you mentioned that he was losing his voice at the halftime. He probably has no voice left now. Poor Bob Hamley.
He wants to win. That's why he's a good coach. 13-13. His team has roared back in this quarter from a 13-9 deficit to draw even. And they should have what would be, barring a turnover, the final possession of regulation time to try and win it. The Eastern Conference All-Stars have won the last two games and looked like they were well on their way. And had it not been for Dietrich down the stretch, might be the Eastern Conference looking for a way to draw even.
Absolutely. Elliott gave his team a chance to win, and Dietrich's been holding them in, holding in the East.
That save that Elliott just made seconds ago was just fabulous. Here we go. Late in the game, last possession. Molaski, one of the reasons this game is tied. Proud. What a pass behind his back. Here's Ratcliffe. He scores. Lewis Ratcliffe's fourth of the day with 4.4 seconds left. The Calgary Roughneck. Has he delivered the knockout punch?
And this was this is actually a little dangerous. They started this play with about 10 seconds left on a shot clock. But Ratcliffe gets a shot with 4 seconds to go. If there had been an interception at the empty net, they would have been in trouble, but they executed perfectly. And Ratcliffe has quietly turned in a fantastic performance. 4 goals, and I have to say he's one of the candidates for MVP.
Comeback by the Western Conference, down 13-9 at one point in this quarter. 5 unanswered goals to lead it 14-13. First lead for the Western Conference since it was 7-6 in the second quarter. It was tied at the half That's seven. And look at the expression on Bob Hamley's face.
Well, he's loving it.
Is he ever. Still 4.4 to go.
Faceoffs are so important. Peter Locke is taking it for the West. I think that's Phil Sanderson for the East. And Locke will probably, he doesn't care if he gets it or not. He wants to make sure Sanderson doesn't get it cleanly.
He didn't.
Oh, look at this. They called him on the quick. I think they called Peter Locke on the quick draw. No, they're doing it over.
Well, they're going to have to put some time back on the clock, and they've done so. So here we go, 4.4. Can you turn this into a goal? No, you won't.
That's it.
The Western Conference for the first time knocks off the Eastern Conference to win the All-Star game in dramatic fashion. Lewis Ratcliffe's fourth of the game, leading all goal scorers with 4.4 to go, wins it for the West.
That was a great effort. A lot of All-Star performances. Mark Steenhuis played great. Looked like he could have had 4 or 5 goals if not for Dallas Elick. And I think Dallas Elick was one of the key players out there as well. It looked like the East was going to run away with it for a while, but as we've seen the last two nights, it's not over till it's over.
No, it is not. What a wonderful finish. We'll be back to hand out some hardware and recap what was a fun finish.
The Denver Nuggets are on Altitude Sports and Entertainment.
Boykins, Miller, and your Denver Nuggets head home to Pepsi Center, where they push for a season sweep against Michael Redd and the Bucks. Bucks Nuggets. The coverage begins Monday at 6:30, only on Altitude.
Every week, Altitude hits the streets of Denver seeking out the local hotspots you want to know about. Join Kyle Keefe around the town as he checks out Denver's favorite festivals, theaters, sporting events, restaurants, shops, and more. Plus, we sit down with Hollywood's hottest stars and go behind the scenes of their latest movies. There's never a dull moment around the town. Wednesday at 5 on Altitude.
The Lacrosse League on Rogers Sportsnet. Brought to you by Future Shop and Toshiba. Proud sponsors of the 2006 National Lacrosse League. And by Molson Canadian. For true Canadian taste from Canada's oldest brewery, it starts here.
Time to present the All-Star MVP out of this fine contest. And here is our public address announcer, Bruce Barker.
Fans, all of today's West All-Star players and the two coaches will receive a DVD player each, courtesy of Future Shop and Toshiba. Presenting the All-Star Game MVP Award is National Lacrosse League Deputy Commissioner and General Counsel, George Daniel. The MVP from the Calgary Roughnecks, Lewis Ratcliffe. In addition to the MVP trophy, Lewis will receive a mobile audio player from Toshiba. Congratulations, Lewis.
Lewis Ratcliffe, 4 goals, Brian, including the game winner with 4.4 seconds left in the contest. And what a comeback by the Western Conference in the fourth quarter.
Absolutely. Lewis Ratcliffe does what he always does best. He just finds a way to put it in the back of the net. Calgary, he's like this as well. Sometimes you don't really notice him until you look at the score sheet, and he's always got 3 or 4 goals. He led the team in scoring last year. He leads Calgary in scoring this year. And a great game and a great worthy choice for MVP.
And the 24-year-old from Victoria, British Columbia is with our Sam Cosentino.
Thanks very much, Peter. Sensational performance for yourself, Lewis Ratcliffe. Name the game's MVP, and I really noticed the intensity of this game picking up as the fourth quarter started to move on.
Yeah, definitely. It was
The beginning was a little rough, and we were throwing the ball away, but they definitely picked it up at the beginning of the second half, and we just had to match them, so it was nice to come back at the end.
Knowing the East had won the last two games, there was a lot of bragging rights on the line, and there was a lot of excitement on the bench after this win.
Oh, yeah, no, we treat it as a regular season game. We like to win. The West doesn't get enough credit for having a lot of good lacrosse players, so it was nice to beat the East.
Talk about your entire experience over the weekend and how much you've enjoyed it.
You know, whenever you get to get together with these guys, it's an awesome time, and Toronto does a great job with whatever they do, so it was a good time.
All right, thanks so much for your time.
No problem, thank you.
That's Lewis Ratcliffe, the game's MVP. He's tied for second in the National Lacrosse League with two game winners and does it again here tonight for the West.
Yeah, this is one he'll never forget. In his second All-Star appearance, John Tavares has now played in five. He's on the losing end after scoring the overtime winner last year in Calgary. Our next Future Shop National Lacrosse League game of the week comes your way on Friday when the Toronto Rock entertain the Minnesota Swarm. This afternoon at the Air Canada Centre in Toronto, these stars of the National Lacrosse League put on a show that everyone could dance to. This young man did a little dancing, Mark Steenhuis. Two goals and two assists. The goaltending was fabulous. There was a little of everything. And a veteran named Dallas Elliott, boy, did he play well down the stretch. For Brian and Sam and our entire crew, so long from the Air Canada Centre.